So we're underground looking for dark matter. And actually, there's been scientists like Lord Kelvin that have proposed the existence of something out there called dark matter, something massive that we cannot see since the late 1800s. But it wasn't really until the 70s when scientists like Vera Rubin did her pioneering measurements of our galaxy and noticed that, you know, stars at the center of the galaxy were spinning just as fast as stars on the edge of the galaxy. And that was kind of an anomaly, because from the laws of Isaac Newton, who was then and still remains a scientist of great renown today, we expect that as the stars get further away from the galactic center, they should move at a slower rate. But what she measured proved the exact opposite. So that gave rise to this theory for the existence of dark matter. And since then, everywhere we look in the universe, whether studying the cosmic microwave background or studying galaxies going through each other, we've always seen the need for dark matter in order to explain our observations. So ever since the 70s, there's been stronger and stronger case for dark matter, and we are trying to directly detect it in a laboratory setting here at the Boulby Underground Laboratory. The detector we're looking at here is called the ZEPLIN II detector, which is very special because it was the first detector to use a dual-phase liquid xenon TPC technology. And what that means is that it has liquid xenon and gaseous xenon inside the detector volume to look for dark matter. And this technology has since been used by large international experiments around the world to look for dark matter, and to date is the most successful and powerful method of looking for dark matter we have around the planet. So from very humble beginnings of the ZEPLIN II detector you see next to me here, current generations of dark matter detector have grown humongously in size to the size of this entire cavern space around me. And the next generation of detectors, which are already being discussed and underway, will be 10 times bigger again. So if they are to be located here at Boulby, we'll have to excavate dedicated caverns in order to host these humongous detectors. So right now we're at the Boulby Underground Screening Facility. And this is a really critical lab to measure the materials used to construct current and future generations of dark matter detector. So what's really special about this laboratory is that it has multiple different detecting techniques to look for radiation so that we can fully understand the levels of contamination in our materials for uranium and thorium and other isotopes. And because the Earth is a radioactive planet, there are levels of uranium and thorium in everything. But don't panic, the levels are super low. It's completely harmless for every day, but our dark matter detectors now have gotten to such a level of size and sensitivity that even the tiniest amounts of uranium can really disrupt our science capabilities. So this lab and these detectors have different methods of detecting radiation so that we can study the uranium and thorium decay chain from the beginning all the way through to the end, which no other lab around the world can do. This lab is a class 1000 clean room, so it's a factor 10 cleaner than the rest of the Boulby Underground Laboratory again. So whereas when coming into the lab, you had to get changed into these white Tevex suits, have special new helmets, we had to put on extra protective equipment to protect us from contaminating this lab. So we're wearing gloves, and we have hair nets, and we had to change into a new white helmet in order to come into the space. And we had to change our boot covers so that we're not bringing any dust into this incredibly clean space. So the team is here today to build a next generation radon detectors, which will be critical for the construction of the next generation of dark matter detector. And that is because despite the radiation purity we've already achieved in building the Lux Zeppelin detector, the entire Lux Zeppelin detector only has 1 gram of dust on the entire detector. And we have the most radio pure cubic meter on the known universe. But despite that level of achievement, we know we need a factor 10 improvement again in terms of our radiation levels in order to achieve the science goals of the next generation of dark matter detector. So the team here today are assembling a new detector that we've designed, which should help us to reach those scientific goals.